talk to me about how far two strangers would go for one another after meeting online. My next guest has a new movie out that dives headfirst into exploring that connection. You know actress Natalie Morales from hit shows like Dead to Me, Girls, and Parks and Rec. She was also the first Cuban in 60 years to lead a network TV sitcom since Desi Arnaz and I Love Lucy with her NBC show Abby's. That's great. That's fantastic. Well, her new movie, Language Lessons, is her second debut as a feature film director, and Screen Rant calls it easily one of the best movies of the year. It's about a Spanish teacher who forms a life-changing friendship with her student entirely over Zoom.
Oh, perdón. Mi nombre es Cariño.
Cariño.
Sí, mi nombre es Caridad, pero todo el mundo me dice Cariño.
¿Qué significa cariño? ¿Qué es?
Cariño quiere decir muchas cosas, pero affection, care, no sé, es un nombre que se me pegó, it stuck, cuando era niña, todo el mundo me lo dice. Es como in Dirty Dancing, how everybody just calls baby, baby.
Natalie joins us now. Welcome to the Tam Fam, Natalie. So good to have you on. Hi.
Hey, everybody. Ooh, are
I know, it's like you're here with us. That's the whole point. You can have a connection even if there's a digital divide. I love that you talk about the judgments or assumptions people make about each other through Zoom, which is really what we are discussing in the show today. How can you have a connection if the connection is technology and not in person? What was the big thing you learned here?
I mean, I think we've all learned that this year, you know? It's so interesting, the assumptions that we make about each other when we meet in person. But via Zoom, you know, like, I can see a little bit inside people's houses, and I can, you know, you can make assumptions about the flowers that are behind me or the stuff that's behind me. And I mean, you're in your studio, Tamron, but I, if you were at home, I could make assumptions about where you live and maybe how much money you have and if you have good taste and if you're messy and if how your life is going. And you know, we thought that was an interesting thing to bring to the table as far as, like, you know, making a movie about that and how we meet people and how those people can affect us and how real we can be with each other online.
I mean, you co-wrote the film, you co-star, you directed, it was shot pretty much by yourself at your home, which is phenomenal in itself. That's a huge feat. I'm curious, so watching the evolution of people, to your point, in their Zooms at home, at first when it started, we were all showing our real home, then people started getting virtual backgrounds, and then I started to put the black wall up, which I felt like looked like I was hiding something, so I put the black wall down, you know. We started to also evolve because, to your point, we recognized that people were judging us by our backgrounds, too.
Yeah, and not only I don't know about you, it's exhausting to be on Zoom, even if for half an hour, even for a day, a regular day of work, because we have to do these sort of, like, exaggerated hand motions and the face motions, and we do all these things in order to be understood, and that's just, like, humans adapting, you know? We want to make sure that our expressions come across right and people are understanding us, and that's so tiring because it's a totally different language.
Which is why I love, again, you're exploring this in this movie, because to your point, let's erase the background, how we connect with each other. The two of us are looking at each other right now, and I'm thinking to myself, would it feel different if you were sitting right here versus there? Or have we tricked our minds into feeling this connection?
I think, yeah. I mean, humans adapt to things, you know? And I mean, it would feel different if I was in front of you. You probably smell great, as your earlier guest was saying. And that's a big, I mean, just by looking at you, I can tell you probably smell amazing. But that's a big thing, and there's a warmthness in a room, and there's a warmthness, and there's also, you know, a body language that doesn't really happen via Zoom. You know, people lean towards each other. Those things don't happen, but other things do start to happen, whereas you can look into each other's eyes in a way that isn't off-putting. Yeah. You can really concentrate on someone, and once those little behaviors start to fall away, once you do this long enough, you kind of allow those barriers to come down and you become yourself more. I mean, how many Zooms have we been in with the same person where instead of me being like this, I'm like,
Right.
You know, like we've all had those.
Yeah, and I love it that you are, you look so beautiful. The earrings, the top, it's just absolutely one of my favorite combinations, red and pink. I say that though to say, at some point people stopped even showing up dressed up. And I am now seeing more people dressing up and treating it like we're in the room together and that I'm not in your basement with you. Eating popcorn, that we're actually dressed up for work.
At least on the top, Tamron, I am wearing pajamas on the bottom. I can see you're wearing heels, but I got pajama pants and I got like hot slippers on. It's just the top.
I love it because there's the love of Zoom and the deception we can still have. Yes. I like it. Well, congratulations on this. You directed it, co-created it, shot it. Congratulations on this. Awesome.
Thank you. Thank you so much.